Ladies and gentlemen, bid you all welcome back to Dark Souls 3 for the final recording session of the evening, I think. This and all the previous episodes were all recorded immediately after launch, so you'll pardon me if any of you, you know, address anything in the comments that I do not bring up here in the episode. Then again, I ask that you all abstain from posting spoilers of any kind. So, if you post comments to that effect, I probably won't respond to it anyway. But regardless, it is time to move on. Let's see what kind of horrible things, such as horrible crossbow guys, we got going on here. Oh, hello, fool.
Ow!
And we got more trousers, great. So, that chapel there, I believe, is the boss. Or at least it was in the network test, so... it is what it is. I'm curious what that is, but if we go there... we'll have to pass the Hussar man again. But, let's give it a shot. Nothing ventured, nothing gained, and it's a ring of sacrifice. And I sincerely hope we do not aggro him from here. There's some kind of blue aura going on down there. Is that an item that I missed? Nope, it's just blue for the sake of being blue. Why are there statues holding their heads? Unless they're just supposed to be holding their helmets and their heads have actually... been knocked off. Ah, what the fucking fuck? Maybe, whoa, what's down there? Alright, well, we'll explore that in due time. I want to see if there's a shortcut we can open. Something about this just screams ambush to me. Hey, you! If only there's a way I could get his attention without having to waste pyromancy. But it is what it is. Oh, bugger. Oh my goodness! That is even worse than the combo swing of Torch Hollows. Good gracious. Alright, well, unfortunately, we have to whittle down our flask uses. Oh, now this looks familiar. Let's wreck the joint. Now, a lot of people were having crashes, apparently, and I seem to be the lucky one who has not had to deal with any of that. As I suspected. Alright, great. And more throwing knives. So, at least there are shortcuts aplenty. Or is this even a shortcut? This does not look all that familiar. I think it's a shortcut of some description. It's maybe not a shortcut to a place I've been before. Oh, bollocks. Okay. I know where this is. There's a bonfire up there. That's the first one we started at. In order to get there, we need Crossbow Fool dead. At the very least. Let's see. Right. Well, it automatically equips some bolts for me. What on earth are you doing? Oh, snap! They actually did it! Holy shit, I don't believe it. So it doesn't automatically reload. Sweet, that is actually a very good thing. That means you don't have to... Oh god, those things look horrifying. Those are even worse than the fucking Bloodborne zombie dogs. Let's see if we can take them out. The handy one of these. Didn't quite kill him. Youch. Yeah, deal with it. It wasn't what I was trying to do, but so be it. Alright, so I didn't even think you could go this way. I kind of assumed that this way was blocked off. And then you could only get there if you wanted to drop over the edge. So this level is actually pretty sprawling, all things considered. I just don't know if that holds true of all levels. No. I should probably try and test to see... To see if how long you charge the weapon art for this affects how much damage it does. Alright, so unfortunately I gotta remember that you need to reload this thing. Oh shit, he's fast. Holy smokes, I did not think he got up here already. Wait. He didn't. That was a ghost. Where the hell did he go? Oh, he's over there. What the dick? How do you even do that? I'm confused. I can't hit him. That's obnoxious. Seriously, how the hell did you do that? Right, well, hopefully he is effectively harmless there. Look at her. You sorry fool. Yeah, bark all you want. And kablooey. Yeah. I know your tricks. We got a halberd bro over there. There's a great axe bro down there. I don't think he's gonna come up here though. Alright, halberd guys are tough. Let's not forget that. Alright, well, nice triple threat combo there seemed to do the trick. Nothing really special along this here, whatchacallit. A lot of screeching zombies about the place. And crossbow guy. Oh, no. Oh, shit, I'm stuck. At least fire works well against these guys. But goddamn, they suck. Jesus Christ, if these guys exist in the starting level, I don't know what I'm gonna do with myself! Good lord. Motherfucker. This has gotta be a joke. Which way is he bloody facing? Oh! Oh, that was a tricks you. All that for goddamn shard. Two shards and an ember. Oh, well. Still not worth it. And we got a bow. Oh, there's nothing even to do up here. I did get a flask back. That's pretty dope. So I guess, something similar to the, kindling mechanic in the, first one, where if somebody kindled the last bonfire you rest at, you get an extra recharge on your Estus. So something similar to that must be happening here, but I'm not sure how that works just yet. Oh, that missed. And I'm out of focus. Oh my god. Should not be able to delay your combo for that long. That is bogus. I want to go back. I don't really want to go back. Even though we would get our focus back. Alright, well, that was not terribly productive, but, well, we have a shortcut now. Why did I not even bother to go level up? You should do that. Oh, so you can still do that without focus. Interesting. Wonder if the effectiveness of it just gets reduced. It's a decent attack in its own right, but I think its main effect is supposed to be to break through guard. Alright, let's get back, do some leveling up. Alright, shall we attune ourselves? I think we shall. Get a few more casts out of this fireball. Farewell, Ashen Maiden. Man, did she say... Welcome home, speak. Farewell, may the flames guide thee. That's an Ulysilian quote, if I do recall. Anybody have anything new to say?
What a sick basket.
Nope. Wonder if that, petty thief shows up anywhere. Well, I don't see nothing. I'm sure more characters start kind of like congregating here at some point, but for now, everybody here is effectively useless. At least as far as information goes.
Fret not, for I am. No star fuck.
Alright, you got nothing for me. Alright, back to Lothric. Drake Bloodhelm. Drake Bloods were in the second game. I wish I had read that description more thoroughly. Instead of dealing with these fools, why don't we just shortcut it? Oh, wow! You were the combos, mate. What is up with you? That is obnoxious. Now I'm wondering something. Oh, that is good. Okay. See, the problem in Dark Souls 2 was that if you tried to follow up a strong swing with a normal swing, you would have to wait for the recovery animation. Which was really stupid. It meant you could not combo normal and strong swings. Which, in my opinion, was immensely stupid. Like, immensely. Stab. Alright, I think we're getting the hangs of this. So, where did we come from again? Right, there's a crossbow guy, isn't there? Right here. We cleaved his brains out, didn't we? Okay. Illusory wall? I think not. Oh, we missed an item here. That's a red knight. Or corpse souls. Oh, there's two red knights. That's just lovely. Three red knights. And some spear soldiers down there. Is there a way to take a shortcut here? Sure seems it. You look different. You got more armor than most of these guys. Those there look like the turtle dudes from the intro. They all seem to be corpses. Come on, lock onto the... Man, the lock-on range is terrible in this game. That's what I'm talking about, fool. We got more throwing knives, didn't we? Might as well use these to pull enemies. Come on. These guys are just as timid as they were in the first game. Oh god, there's another one. Now that one is not pulling. I want to keep it that way. Yeah, lovely. Alright, so we know that that skill works to great effect. Perfect. Avoid the red knights. We will deal with them in due time. There sure are a hell of a lot of their armors around. A lot of these turtle shell... I think of them as pilgrims, because that's what it seemed like they were doing in the intro. And this looks like the boss arena. Or at least a boss arena. Fatty ahead. Oh. I think there are two bosses here. And I think I know which one this is, based on the description. I've seen it in the trailers. It's like a big tubby dude with a mace who crawls on all fours. If that's the case, I am in no way prepared for this. But based on what I know of the other boss, I think this guy might actually be a little bit easier. What to do? Fuck it, give it a try. Maybe we get something like an asylum demon. But with nowhere to run. This is peculiar. Oh dear. Yep, that's what I thought it was. What a dreadful monstrosity. Okay, he seems slow so far, but you know it's not gonna stay that way. Imagine letting him corner me. It's probably a terrible idea. Okay, he did a lot of some kind of status effect there. Okay, well. That was an awful start. Doesn't seem to have that much health, though. Oh, dear. Alright. No matter. Now, why does that do damage? Well, it's not far enough to fall to do damage. Oh, gracious. Mm-hmm. Well, then. Perform this with more care and caution. Got a whole 30 souls back. Alright, Mr. Jumpy Axe Man. Yeah, have it. You are weak. You are feeble. You are nothing to me. Round two. Nope, not even close. Yowza. Hmm. It's not difficult to get underneath. And I got hit. Gracious. Oh, my goodness. Nope, that does shit. Oh, he's doing an AoE, isn't he? Nope, he just buffed. Great. Oh, heavens above. I couldn't even see. Oh, good lord. Well, I mean, he's not bad until he reaches his second form, in which case he turns out to be horrible. Nice. Come on, do something. Whoa! Dudes, look at that! Oh my god, what the fuck? Look at this! So sprinting R2 becomes a jump attack. I did not know that. That is pretty cool. Well, shit. I'm already wounded, which means this will not go well. Oh, what the fuck was that? Are you insane? God, just stop moving so much. Oh my god! That's bullshit. Oh, look at that. Are you mad? The fuck do you think you're doing? You're not gonna hit me from there. God damn, that just makes this more annoying. I'll kill this guy. Can you... Why is a lock on lane range so short? There. Oh, this boss is gonna be a pain in the dick. Maybe we should try the other one first. What the fuck was that madness? Alright. So there's a bunch of red knights. Well, it looks like there's something more over there, so maybe we should explore that first. Let's get this fool's attention. Great. Fucking lock on is terrible. Nope. That's what I'm talking about. The spear ones seem tougher than the sword ones. Why don't we just ignore that guy and go after this one? Oh, goodness gracious. Oh, wow, he had poison, that one. Or hyper-armor, as it were. Whoa! That's not a weapon I was expecting to get this soon. Nice. So is it even possible to use the weapon arts? Oh, look at that. Now, I think that's supposed to be a guard break move based on the description. Oh, no, maybe not. Now, that's interesting because you don't have to hold the button to trigger that. But I'm a little confused. Whoa, look at that madness. So that's an L2 into an R2. Well, that is pretty dope. Going through a lot of my focus points doing that, though, so probably should not. Great Axe takes a ludicrous amount of strength. Now, trying to figure out what... how much does two-handing affect the strength? Because in the first one, it gave you a 50% bonus. In the second one, I think it was 100%, but I can't really remember. I guess that's another growl. That seems to be common to axe weapons. Right, well, there's nothing special here. So fighting that guy was specifically to acquire the Lucerne. For what that's worth. There's a guy up there. Is he an NPC? Or an enemy? You look taller than a human. You don't look like you're about to go ham and try and kill me. Nope, you're gonna go ham and try to kill me. So, oh shit, bugger.
Ow!
Good lord. Well, you're something special, aren't you? This is altogether not a very productive episode, is it? And another crossbow. Fan-fucking-tastic. Alright, come on, you dirty fool. Oops, not what I meant. Where are you coming from? Well, that's annoying. Yeah, eat it. Ow. Good lord, is this a joke? Ouchie. Wish they had the Metal Gear Solid chicken hat in this game. Because I could sure use it right now. And granted, I'm just getting careless because I don't really care all that much. Which I suppose is the definition of careless. But it is what it is. Why am I doing such stupid things? Fuck it. Whoa. Okay. Now, this was a boss arena in the network test. There's no NPC in here before. Well, I'm glad they changed it, so at least you don't know what to expect.
The wait has been long, unkindled one. I am Emma, High Priestess of Lothric Castle. Allow me to speak frankly. You will not find the Lords of Cinder here. They have left, gone, to their churning homes converging at the base of this castle. Head to the bottom of the high wall, forge on through the great gate, and raise this banner to proceed.
Interesting.
This farewell gift is for you. It is the insignia of an old covenant. If you fear trespassers, dark spirits drawn by the embers, then etch this upon your heart, and the old Concord will beckon noble blue sentinels to hunt these foul spirits.
Alright, so the blue sentinels still exist, it seems. How the hell do all these covenants survive the passage of time and kingdoms? I will never know.
Unkindled one, head to the high wall's base. Go through the great gate, but beware. The dog keeps a close eye on things.
Sorry, what was that?
Unkindled goes but the vile watchdog of the Boreal Valley.
Alright, so that's that, Vort, or whatever the fuck his name is. That, nasty, horrible flying dog with the mace thing. Sorry, I probably shouldn't be destroying the furniture here. That's just disrespectful. Why can't I get out of my way? That's a shame. So there's nothing else to be done here. Unless this altar has something. It appears not to. That looks like... What sword is that? That sword looks familiar. I mean, it looks similar to Artorias's, but specifically something I know I've seen before. It actually looks a lot like, I think, the Iron Claymore or Great Sword in Skyrim. No big deal. Alright, well, unfortunately, we could not dispense with the boss before this episode was done, but it is what it is. Let's see. We can do something with this fool. Cheese the bastard. Oh, damn it. I was out of stamina. Shit. I almost had him, too. Oh, dear. Alright, well, screw it. That's that, ladies and gentlemen. Hope you all enjoyed the episode, despite my incompetence. Hopefully next time we will actually be able to pull something off for a change. Until then, thank you all for watching. If you enjoyed, leave a like. If not, do whatever you want. Otherwise, be sure to follow me on Twitch, subscribe to my archive channel, both linked in the description, and I will see you all next time. Fare thee well.